Hey friends, as we all know, Azure Cosmos DB is a globally distributed database service for building highly available, scalable, and fast applications. And here's one of the things that I really love about it. There's always something new to discover. My good friend Kirill Gavrylyuk is back once again to give me an update on two exciting new things. Something called Autopilot and, pause for effect, a free tier offering today on Azure Friday. Hey, it's Azure Friday. I'm Scott Hanselman. I'm here with Kirill Gavrylyuk, and we're talking about Cosmos, the February update. It's 2020. We're well into the year now, and Cosmos DB continuing to kick butt all over the earth, globally distributed database. What is Autopilot?
It's great to be here, Scott. Thank you for having us. And first, we're going to talk about Autopilot. This is a way to configure your container or database in Cosmos DB to automatically and instantly scale throughput capacity depending on your needs.
Really?
So for example, and it's been a common challenge where folks, let's say I want to move a MongoDB application.
Right.
We support MongoDB API, it works. Let's say you've tested it. Yeah, it seems like working. I want to move. How much RUs do I need to provision?
I literally have that problem because I've got an application. My blood sugar management system uses Mongo, does a little post every few seconds, maybe every couple of minutes. But I run reports, and the RUs that I will need to do my regular kind of heartbeat are going to be very different than these massive, you know, data analysis things that I'm going to need to do once or twice. So I want it to scale up, but I'd have to do it manually now.
Exactly, and you don't know how much.
I guess.
And many people do. In fact, most people do because it's such a it's a thing that only Cosmos DB has. And so Autopilot takes this question out of the equation. Mm-hmm. You walk into Cosmos DB, and here I have a MongoDB API account.
Okay,
I'm going to create a new database. As you know, and we recommend to everyone, if you don't want to pay too much with Cosmos DB, you always provision throughput at the database level.
Right.
Right. So that all your collections share the same capacity.
Okay.
I type some name, and I can now choose autopilot mode. I can choose manual mode. I can provision these RUs if I know what I'm talking about and I know how much I need. But I don't know either. I don't know what I'm talking about, or I don't know the capacity I need. And I choose how much. What is the limit?
What limit
do I don't want to exceed? And the usual answer to that question, I look at the pricing page. How much RUs are? Okay. And then I don't want to pay more than $50.
Right.
Ever. Just when reach to that limit, just stop and tell me that I'm asking for too much. So let's say I don't want to ever exceed 4,000 RUs. What this will do is it will always keep you at 400 RUs and only scale up if you really need to. Only if your workload really needs to, it'll scale you up immediately and instantly scale you down.
Really? I don't have to do anything?
You don't have to do anything.
Change my code?
Nope. Mm-hmm. Well, let's try it, actually.
All right.
So here I have one of the examples where this is handy is, let's say I want to move my data using Mongo import, right? This is a tool that none of us in Microsoft ever wrote or contributed to. MongoDB import, but it's a standard way of ingesting smaller scale databases, Mongo databases, into Mongo, and it works with Cosmos DB Mongo API. So here I have Mongo import, and I'm pointing it at my account, the ones that I showed you, and I have it. I'm giving you passwords, secrets, etc., and I'm pointing it at the database called provisioned.
Okay.
And my database called provisioned is configured with 1,000 RUs. Let's just say I don't know what those RUs are for, but I choose 1,000. I like the number. Maybe it's enough.
Yeah, and you got $2 a day, so you're good.
So let's run it and see what happens. And the amount of data we're inserting is not that high, maybe a couple tens, maybe 20,000 records or something like that.
Okay.
This tool immediately starts erroring out with 16,500. What does it mean? Why is it erroring out?
So you're actually getting insert errors right now because it's trying to insert as fast as it can.
Exactly, because it thinks, okay, this is a Mongo running on a VM somewhere, and the faster it responds to me, the faster I'm going to push.
Oh, it doesn't throttle. It just throws data as fast as it can.
And when Cosmos DB sends back, hey, you're doing too fast, we're sending that response very fast. It's like, hey, you exceeded your limit very fast.
Shouldn't the Mongo application learn to back off?
But this Mongo application was written against MongoDB. You can't blame it.
Okay.
It was written against the MongoDB server, and so it's
so
editing out.
So now you're in a weird state. Maybe some of the documents made it, some didn't.
Maybe not exactly. So, and I cannot edit the code. Maybe I could probably get it on GitHub.
Right.
I could get
teach it.
I could change
it.
Teach it to retry. But why? Instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to point it at Autopilot. An Autopilot database is configured with maximum 4,000 RUs, but it will stay at 400 unless it needs to move up, right? And so now I'm going to point it at Autopilot.
How do I know if 4,000 is enough? If it goes as fast as possible, is there an upper limit?
The upper limit is controlled. In case of MongoDB import, it's controlled by how much capacity you have on the client.
I see. So this is pushing it as fast as your laptop can push
exactly.
it right now.
Exactly. And so let's do it. Again, it's the same line item, except I changed instead of database provisions, I'm pointing at Autopilot.
All right.
And now it's
drops it
going.
And then goes again.
And it keeps going. You don't
so
get
it
any
is scaling sorts. Up, and it's as fast as your laptop can throw it.
Exactly.
Just for the just for the time being, it's scaled up.
Yep. And then it immediately scales
stop.
Down. Mm-hmm. And so over time, what I'm doing is I'm actually saving money. I'm paying much less than 1,000 RUs.
Right,
fixed.
Because you're going to pay a little bit for this, but then you'll go away, it'll be done, and you're going to pay the minimum then.
Exactly.
It'll drop back down to the minimum threshold, 400.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And so this is just one example. In generally, a good rule of thumb, if you know exactly how much RUs, first, if you really understand what RUs are, and you know exactly, you read the documentation, and you know exactly how much RUs your application needs, and you have control over your application, then if you know exactly what it needs, provision throughput is always cheaper. Because you pre-provision capacity, of course, we're giving it to you cheaper. But if you don't know, Autopilot will always be more cost effective.
So that successfully did 30,000 or 25,000 documents, and that's working correctly.
Yep, and it's right here.
And do people just have that now? That's in preview, but people can go and just find that when they already have a Mongo instance. They already have a Cosmos instance, perhaps using Mongo.
Yep.
They can go and do that right away.
Yep. And it's available. The only reason it's preview, right now we only support it for new collections and databases. By the time we GA, we'll enable it to existing collections and databases
existing collections.
As well.
I see.
We're still working on, because you saw, we only have a few set of max RUs available.
Mm-hmm.
This will, by the time this episode airs, we'll support arbitrary setting, how much max RUs you can do. We'll add a lot more bells and whistles. You can potentially auto-increase max just with some delay, because mm-hmm. we actually have to bring hardware.
Right.
You can do lots of things, but it's instant. If you set Autopilot, you will never see 429 unless you exceed that max, absolute max that you set.
The 429 client yes. exceeded errors.
Yes, that's why we call it Autopilot. It is not like auto-scaling VMs, auto-scaling sites.
Mm-hmm.
There is no delay. We're not looking at any metrics. We're handling it right when the request comes in.
Right, with a VM or an Azure app service, it reaches a threshold. There's a threshold that has been passed, and then there's a moment, and then it goes and scales up
right.
or scales out, and it's like, could be seconds, could be a minute, you don't know, depending
right.
on what you're using.
Exactly.
So Autopilot is not auto-scale, it's better.
It's instant. Mm. That's why.
Okay, so that solves a problem for
yep.
me. That's good to know. Another problem that I've had is I love Cosmos, but for little stuff, for my little project here, like I know that it's $24 a month, which is great for enterprises, but I don't have $24 a month for every little toy website that I'm making. So how can I love Cosmos, but not want to spend 20 bucks every time I make a website and I want a database?
And I tell you, for the past 3 years, it was my personal goal to get Cosmos DB somehow free edition so you don't have to scratch your head and say, well, I don't want to pay $24 if I don't even know whether my app will succeed.
Yeah.
Why should I? So I'm pretty excited to announce that we are offering free tier in Cosmos DB. It's available now, and you any subscription you have is entitled for up to 400 RUs capacity, whether it's provisioned or autopilot or multi-master. You get 400 RUs included, free of charge, perpetually.
Perpetually. This is part of the free offering. So I go to azure.com/free, which is a list of all of the great free offerings. This is one of them.
It's even more so. It's more like free website. So irrespective what type of your subscription is, you may have an EA subscription, pay-as-you-go subscription, whatever offer, whatever subscription.
Okay, so like App Service has free and shared and basic and whatnot. This is a new tier.
This is a new tier. This is a free tier in Cosmos DB available for any subscription type, and you get up to 5 gigabytes of Cosmos DB SSD storage and up to 400 RUs free of charge perpetually.
I'm just thinking right now, I might be able to move my diabetes system over tonight.
I think so. And the reason that is possible is not only we do that, we used to have this limit that you have to have at least 100 RUs provisioned per collection in a database.
Yeah, see, everyone organizes their Mongo databases differently. And some people have everything in one collection. I happen to have 7 or 8 collections, but they're very small. I think I've got 500 megs total across a bunch of, but they're logically oriented collections. And Cosmos's original per collection pricing model didn't match my usage model.
Exactly. And even when we announced provisioning throughput at the database level, initially we said, yes, you can share, but if you have 10 collections, you should have at least 1,000 RUs provisioned at the database. So this 100 RUs per limit
right.
per collection.
And again, this RU is resource
yes.
unit or like it's just
it's a request, yeah,
but request unit? I just don't know
exactly
what an RU is yet. It's a currency I'm not yet familiar with. So until you spend time with Cosmos and get a feeling of what an RU feels like, you won't know whether 400 or 1,000 or 10,000 is what your app needs.
So we are removing that limit.
Mm.
It doesn't matter how many collections you have in the database.
Love it.
You can provision 400 RUs.
Across the collections.
Across all collections in your database.
Right.
You have 400 RUs. You're not paying for it a dime.
Love it.
Because it's free and included.
This is going to open things up for hobbyists, for people trying things out, for people who are kicking the tires.
I think so. And of course, this is available in addition to all the other free benefits that we have as part of Cosmos DB.
Can I autopilot a free
yes.
where I will occasionally pay for that reporting that I do every once
yes.
in a while?
Yes. So that's a good thing, a cool thing where you can configure free tier for an autopilot database, and then you will pay only for the delta.
That's hot. That's really cool because, again, I've got a little heartbeat and a very small couple hundred megs of data to manage my blood sugar, but then I run reports, and when I do, I want them now.
Yeah.
And currently on my Mongo hosted system running in Azure under a partner's subscription, I have to wait because it's so slow to run these reports. And I love the idea that I could spike,
yep.
have the full power of Cosmos, give me that data quickly, and then go back to my free tier at the end.
And you only pay for that spike.
I love it. I love it. I want it. Can I have it?
Yes. Now that this aired.
This is happening. So if you are watching this show, you have these great features too. Like we heard about autopilot happening for new stuff and being going into existing databases soon.
Yep.
And the free tier available now. So be sure to check that out. Fantastic. Always lovely to see you talking about Cosmos with such passion on Azure Friday.
Thank you, Scott. I always love to be here. Thank you for having me.
Go and check it all out. So many great things happening with Cosmos DB, and I'm learning all about it today on Azure Friday.